a lot of famous people out of my entire time in the federal prison system. I mean, it's just common. It's the feds. But one particular famous guy that I met and what really sticks out was the Somali pirate. Yes, the one they made the movie from. His name is Abdul Wali Musa. Fun fact, he was actually 16 when he caught this case. The government had no idea what his age was and gave him a random age, okay? He was, if you guys remember watching the movie, there were four hijackers. Three of them were killed. One of them actually survived, and that was him. Now, some people in the comments were asking me, how was the U.S. able to take custody of him? This was the United States. However, what I've learned is whatever ship that flag carries happens to be that country's jurisdiction. So since it was an American ship with an American flag, there it became an American issue. Okay. After they put him in custody, they brought him to New York. There he went to Manhattan Correctional Institution, and there he spent numerous amount of time, in fact, years in solitary confinement. After he was sentenced to 30 years in prison. The prosecutor wanted to give him a life sentence, and the judge wanted to give him a second chance at life, okay? So after he was sentenced to 30 years, there they transported him to Terre Haute, Indiana. He did about 6 to 7 years at a CMU unit. That is a controlled management unit. It's a unit that is away from general population. And the whole point of that is to monitor your emails, monitor your phone calls. Inmates such as like terrorists or people that have national security cases, they put him in there to monitor them. So he did about 6 to 7 years and they put him to general population. There, I happened to meet him. When I got to the cell block and him and I were on the same cell block, and they told me, he's like, hey, you know, the Somali pirate is here. I said, what? He said, yeah, he's here. Thing is, I am Muslim. So I was riding with the Muslims. He is also Muslim as well. So him and I got to know each other on the basis of being brothers in the faith and getting to know each other personally. And I got to spend about 4 months with this guy, man. Honestly, a very, very humble guy. Okay, the movie portrayed him as like this bloodthirsty savage, and that was not the case. He was always smiling, always laughing. He picked up the English language while he was incarcerated. He didn't even know a lick of English. He was able to obtain his GED while he was locked up. He was always praying. He was always reading, you know, always just trying to make everybody's day pretty much better. All the inmates in the prison wanted a picture with him because this guy is a celebrity. So it didn't matter what race or what group that person belonged to. They wanted a picture with him because he was a celebrity. And I've gotten a few pictures with him, and that was awesome. He gained hella weight while he was locked up. I mean, this guy was like literally like a stick, and he lived in Somalia. It was an impoverished country. Okay. So he definitely gained weight from the commissary of all the noodles and rice and, honey buns, things like that, man. And rightly so. There was actually a accusation that his mom disowned him and want nothing to do with him. But I found out since I've been home that that's not the case, that his mom is actually asking for him and love him and miss him. So that is something that needs to be brought up as well. Listen, the guy was 16 when he caught his case. I'm in no way, shape, or form justifying his crime, but he lived in an impoverished poor country. And that was the only way that he was going to support his family and himself. Okay. I honestly, though, talking to him, he definitely regrets his crime and definitely regrets his actions. And he gets a second chance at life. He'll be out while around. He's about 40 years old and he gets a second chance to do the right thing. You know, there was other things that, I mean, all the staff and all the administration pretty much respected this guy and stayed out of this guy's way. You know, this guy definitely had an aura about him, just this light about him that, you know what, man, even though that he's going to be doing a lot of time in prison, it never really destroyed his spirits. And, you know, he definitely made everybody's day just that much better. He was a very, very good guy to be around, man. And I was really honored to be around him for about 4 months. And right now he is in FCI Jessup, North Carolina, if I believe. But you guys can Google him. His name is Abdul Wali Musa. If you guys don't, like, a lot of people were telling me that's not him or he was killed or this, that, and the third. It's a simple Google search, everybody. Okay. It'll tell you exactly who he is, where he went to, and where he's at right now. Okay. So I have no reason to lie about this situation, you know? But other than that, man, it was pretty much an awesome situation to be in, and I'm really hoping the best for him.